Let's easily and quickly create one simple forest scene using PCG or Procedural Content Generation plugin. It's so powerful that it will allow you to create small and large open worlds with ease, and most of all, it allows you to change it anytime you want with just a few clicks. Don't worry, it's really easy, and as always, I recommend downloading a free PDF guide from the link in the description. This way you will have all the information, values and steps from this video in one place for future reference. So let's start. Go File, click New Level and choose Basic. To move around the editor, hold down the right mouse button and use the W, A, S and D keys to move just like in a standard FPS game. Go up and down with E and Q keys. Save the level first in case it crashes. Go to File, save the current level, name it and hit Save. The next step is creating terrain. Go to Landscape Mode or Shift 2. Over here choose the size. I'll go with 63 by 63. And make sure that this Enable Edit Layers is selected. And the location is 000. Click Create and we got our terrain. Go back to the Selection tool or Shift plus 1. Select the floor on the right side and delete it since we don't need it anymore. To enable the plugin, go to Edit, Plugins, type in Procedural and enable Procedural Content Generation Framework. Unreal will ask you to restart the engine, so restart it. Before we start generating our forest, let's download the forest pack from the Unreal Marketplace. Go to plus button and select Unreal Marketplace. If it won't open, just go to Marketplace in the Epic Games launcher, it's the same. And type in Black Alder in the search bar. Click on the European Black Alder from the Megascans. Click Add to Project. Since we're using 5.2 engine version, we need to click Show All Projects. If you have problems upgrading Unreal to the latest version, this video will help you out. Link is in the description and in the card up here. And select our 5.2 project. Don't worry about the error. Just select 5.1 version and click Add to Project. After the download finishes, you can see your forest in the content browser. To open or close content drawer, press Ctrl Space. I like to dock it by pressing this button here so it's always visible. Here we can see the forest assets that we will use later. Let's create forest floor first. To do that, we need to add landscape material. Go to Add, select Quixel Bridge, make sure to sign in. Over here type in the forest floor and go Surfaces, Grass. Over here choose the one you like. I already have one downloaded, it's located in a local content. Just click the green download button and hit the blue button to add it to the project. Go Content, Megascans, Surfaces. Over here choose your material folder. Now select Landscape in the Outliner and scroll down to see Landscape Material. Now drag and drop Forest Floor Material to the Landscape Material. If I click Play, you can see that our floor is a bit tiny. So we need to double click our material and enable tiling. Over here, change the value to 0.1 for both X and Y tiling. Now our floor looks better. There is a nice feature of the Unreal Engine that allows you to paint over the landscape to make the scene more realistic. Check out this video tutorial to learn more about it. Click on the card up here or check out the description for the link. The first step in generating forest is to go to the green button and type PCG. Select PCG volume and drag and drop it to the landscape. Press End key to land it directly on the landscape. Select PCG volume, go to scale and change it to something like 20. Don't worry, we will expand this later to be much bigger. To control our procedural generation, we need PCG graph. Go to the Content tab, right click and select PCG and select PCG graph. Name it something like PCG1. Now we need to connect this graph with the PCG volume we created. To do this, select PCG volume in the outliner. Under details, select PCG component. Over here, under graph, select our graph we just created. And that's it, the boring part is over, we now move to fun things. Don't forget to save everything with Shift-Ctrl-S. Double-click the PCG graph. As you can see, it's similar to blueprints. Don't worry, it's very easy to set up this. Right-click anywhere and type in Surface Sampler. In this, we control our generation properties like seed, density and so on. I'll show you how a bit later. Now click this arrow to expand the input node. Now connect landscape with surface. To break the connection, hold the Alt key and left click on it. Before we start adding trees, select Surface Sampler and press the D to enable debugging. You should see cubes, but if you don't see them, make sure to select PCG component and click on Generate. And you will see cubes. Those cubes represent where and how your trees will be distributed. This is a good start because it doesn't consume lots of your computer resources. Okay, let's add some trees. Open PCG graph, right-click and type in Static Mesh Spawner. Connect everything as you see. Select Static Mesh Spawner and under Mesh Entries, click the plus button. It will add one entry below. Click it and expand the descriptor. Now hit Ctrl plus space to open the drawer and navigate to the Black Elder. Geometry, Simple Wind, and just drag and drop the tree of your choice to the Static Mesh section. Save everything with Shift Ctrl plus S. As you can see, we have our patch of forest, but we need to remove cubes and wind to make it look good. If you don't see your forest, click Force Dragon in the PCG graph. Or click Generate in the PCG component. Go to PCG graph and select Surface Sampler and hit D on your keyboard. To remove wind, go to Content Browser, type in Actor, and now drag and drop Global Foliage Actor Blueprint to the scene. Select it. And in the right side under Wind Properties, set it to 0. Nice. Let's add more trees to add variety to the scene. Go Graph, Static Mesh Spawner. Under Mesh Entries, click plus button. And add trees just like we did with the first one. As you can see, our forest looks better, but it's small. Click on the PCG volume and in the scale increase number to 50, for example. And we got a large forest. A very powerful feature of the Unreal Engine. This way you can make your forest crazy large. Our forest looks a bit dense, so we go to our PCG graph, select Surface Sampler and over here increase looseness to something like 1.6 to add some space between trees. You can also change the seed to something like 10. This seed property is the way how Unreal will remember the exact position of the trees, so you can use this number to generate the same forest in other projects. Very cool feature. We can also use points per square meter to change density. I'll show you how it works when we are going to add grass to our forest. If I click play, you can see that our forest is pointing all in one direction. So to add some rotation to the trees, go to the PCG graph. Right-click and add Transform Points node. Add it between the Surface Sampler and the Static Mesh Spawner. Connect them. Select Transform Points. Under Rotation Max, type in 90 for example. This way, trees will rotate between 0 and 90 degrees on the Z axis. Before we add some grass, select the nodes and press C on your keyboard to add a comment. Type trees. Okay, we need some grass to populate the forest floor. Go to Quixel Bridge and go 3D Plants. Go Grass and I'll choose Grass Clumps. Download and import. Now try to add grass yourself. It's the same procedure as we did with trees. If not, let's do it together. Type surface sampler, connect landscape, make seed to B20, add transform node, add static mesh spawner, comment on the whole section, and organize a bit. Inside the static mesh spawner, start adding grass, but make sure to disable collision so we can walk through the forest. To do that, add an element. Go Megascans, 3D plants, drag and drop grass to the static mesh. Under collision presets, choose no collision. Now do the same with the other meshes. If you click play, you can see our grass is not as dense as it should be. So go to PCG graph, select surface sampler. Under points per squared meter, type in 2.5. This will tell Unreal to add more points. Also, under point extents, type 10. This point's extent property will make grass to be closer to each other. Also, don't forget to add rotation. And also change this scale min and max a bit to add height variety to our grass. If you click play, you can see that our forest looks good. The last thing to do is to add some atmosphere with lighting and post-process volume. Don't worry, it's very easy to do it. If you want to learn more about lighting, you can check out this video, Lighting Tutorial for Beginners Step by Step. Link is in the description or in the card at the top right corner. Go to Add and type Post Process. Just drag Post Process Volume to the level. Select it and type in Infinite. And make sure that this infinite extent is selected. This will affect the whole scene, not just the post process volume itself. After that, go to Exposure and change the metering mode to manual. And change exposure compensation as you see fit, minus 14. This will remove eye adaptation and fix exposure. Now select exponential height fog and go to volumetric fog and enable it. This will remove the blue tint from the scene. Now it's all up to you how to make the atmosphere. In albedo, change color. Under the extinction scale, change it to see the fog. You can play with these options until you are satisfied. After you are done, hold Ctrl plus L on your keyboard to move the position of the sun. If you find this tutorial helpful, drop some comments below or subscribe to get notified about the new tutorial every week, and be sure to take it slow, don't worry, and keep learning because the Unreal Engine is awesome. See you on some other video. Bye bye.